Can history, myths, legends and development go hand in hand? Most should say no. But if we forget our legends, I fear we shall close an important door on our history and more importantly, our imagination. But today, I'm in a city that has managed to keep its history and its legends alive even as it progresses into the 21st century. Welcome to Apnu Ahmedabad, India's proud World Heritage City. Karnavati, Srinagar, Rajnagar, Ahmedabad, Ahmedabad, all names of the same city. And why not? After all, the city has existed since the 11th century, ruled by the Chalukyas, the Shahs, Mughals, Marathas, and many more. And the multiple gates of this walled city are an apt reminder of the glorious welcome gesture that the city has always extended. Is the same pathway that was once walked upon by the great Mughal Emperor Jahangir. And why not? After all, this pathway leads to the longest as well as the oldest gateways of Ahmedabad city, the Teen Darwaza. Located on the east of the Bhadra Fort, the Teen Darwaza is often associated with historical as well as legendary events. Completed in the year 1415 by Sultan Ahmad Shah, who founded this city, the Teen Darwaza is truly an epitome of fine architecture of the former Gujarat Sultanate. The gateway has three arches which led into a large enclosure forming the outer courtyard of the palace called Maidan Shah in past. The inscription seen here on one of the pillars of the Teen Darwaza dates back to 1812. Maratha governor Chimnaji Raghunath decreed and inscribed this farman on Teen Darwaza, declaring equal rights to women in inheritance of ancestral property. This plaque engraved in Devanagari script dated 10th October 1812 reads, "Let the daughter get her due share of father's property without any hitch. So is Lord Vishwanath's command. If you defy, the Hindu will have to answer Mahadev and the Musliman will have to explain to Allah or Rasul." Legend has it that years ago, watchman Khwaja Siddiqui Kotwal beheaded himself to request Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth, to stay in this city. And that's what led to the prosperity of Ahmedabad. This lamp right here in one of the cavities of the Teen Darwaza has been lit continuously for more than 600 years by a Muslim family in dedication to the legend. There might be an ongoing debate on the number of gates this city has, 12, 16 or 21. What matters most is the fact that irrespective of Ahmedabad being a walled city, its doors have always been open to cultures and religions. This lamp here is a testimony to the integrity and history of Apnu Ahmedabad.